Hey guys, Jordan Winkle here. Thanks so much for watching. You know, gun writers and enthusiasts and bloggers and reviewers don't really have it that easy when it comes to describing a trigger, myself included. As far as I can tell, when it comes time to describe the attributes of a good trigger, use as many of the following terms as possible. Buttery, crisp, smooth, clean, short, sweet, even, consistent, light, dreamy, legendary, epic, perfection, hallmark, natural, ergonomic, pleasurable, fast, awesome. Now if those singular terms aren't enough, you can use some of the following phrases. User-friendly, worth the money, the holy grail, what we've been waiting for, 5-star. Now if a trigger is bad, you can't just say it's bad. You have to include some of the following terms. Gritty, squishy, long, heavy, wiggle, defensive, horrible, horrific, pathetic, unfortunate, disappointing, grindy, and last of all, make sure you talk about the over-travel. Now here's the thing, some of those terms are actually quantifiable attributes of a trigger on a gun. But to me, trying to describe to someone how a trigger feels is like trying to describe to someone how a particular kind of lemonade or chocolate ice cream tastes. Now I get it, you have to say something. And that something has to be descriptive so as to paint a picture to the reader, listener, or viewer. The only thing that really matters with the trigger is does the trigger press allow for an adequate amount of accuracy if the shooter does his or her own part? In other words, is it possible to press the trigger without disturbing the sight picture? After all, if you are able to do that, the bullets are going to go where you want them to go, and that's all that really matters. Guys, thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you in a future video.